Sports Medicine is the most trusted of its kind in Northeast Indiana. That's because of the benefits our services provide you. We serve every level of athlete with our sports nutritionist, the expert physicians at ONE, the area's only specialized athletic rehab, and the region's industry leader in sports performance, AWP. The roster coordinates your care in state-of-the-art facilities conveniently located in your community. To start your journey, visit us at parkviewsportsmedicine.com.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Bishop Luers High School for tonight's non-conference basketball game on a Monday night here on SummitCitySports.com. Well, we've got New Haven versus Bishop Luers here tonight for you. We will preview that game shortly, but right now we're going to start with a quick preview of the Indiana State High School draw. The state draw for boys basketball came out on Sunday night, and we're going to update you on where and when the times and places where these teams will be playing next week. First in the 4A sectional 5. And this sectional is held at Carroll. It will be in the game 1, Northside versus DeKalb at 6 p.m., and that will be next Tuesday night. And then it will be followed by East Noble and Carroll, roughly about 7:30 at Carroll High School. They will then play again on March the 3rd, which will be a Friday night, where Fort Wayne Northrop will play the winner of Northside and DeKalb. And then in the nightcap at 7:30, it will be the Snyder Panthers versus the winner of Carroll and East Noble. And then the championship game will be Saturday at 7 p.m. at Carroll High School between one of those six teams. Snyder has wins over all of the teams in their sectional, including the number one ranked team in the state, the Northside Legends. So that is 4A Carroll. At 4A Wayne, the games are as such. In game 1 on Tuesday night will be Muncie Central versus Jay County at 6 p.m. The winner of that game will take on Huntington North on Friday night at 6. And then the other first round game, it'll be Fort Wayne Southside versus Homestead at 7:30. The winner of that game to play Wayne on Friday night at 7:30. And the winner of the semifinal games will be played, the championship game will be played on Saturday night at 7 p.m. And that is at Wayne High School. In the 3A sectional, at these games will be at Garrett. This is sectional 22. In game 1, in the first round, it will be Leo versus Bishop DeWanger. These games are also on Tuesday night. That will be at 6 o'clock, and then that game will be followed by Fort Wayne Concordia versus Angola. And then in the semifinal round, New Haven will await the winner of Leo DeWanger. That game will be Friday night at 6. Garrett gets a bye. They will play the winner of Concordia and Angola at 7:30. The winner of the semifinal games to play in the championship game at 7:30 on Saturday night, March the 4th. And now for the other sectional there at Belmont. This will be sectional 23. The first game on Tuesday night will be Mississinawa versus Heritage. That will be at 6 o'clock. That game will be followed by Belmont versus Columbia City at 7:30. The winner of Mississinawa Heritage will play Concordia on Friday, or excuse me, Bishop Luers on Friday night at 6. And then the winner of Belmont and Columbia City will play Norwell Friday night at 7:30 at Belmont High School. The winners of those games also will meet at 7:30 on Saturday night. In the 2A bracket, at Woodland High School, in the first game on Tuesday night at 7 p.m. will be Cherubusco versus South Adams. In the second game, it will be Bluffton versus Fort Wayne Christian. And then there is also another first round game, and that game will be actually, those are Tuesday. That Tuesday game is Cherubusco South Adams. Wednesday night it'll be Bluffton Canterbury at 6 p.m. and then at 7:30 Adams Central East Side to follow at 7:30. And then the semifinal game will pit the winner of Busco and South Adams against Woodland, and then the winners of Bluffton Canterbury and Adams Central East Side will meet in the semifinal to play in the championship game on Saturday night. That is the Woodland 2A sectional bracket. And then at the 2A sectional 37 Oak Hill, it'll be Cass versus Manchester. That will be the only Tuesday night game. That will be played at 7 o'clock. And then on the 1st of March, Wabash versus Oak Hill at 6 and Northfield versus Southwood at 7:30. Rochester will await the Cass Manchester winner on Friday night at 6, and the winners of Wabash Oak Hill will play the winner of Northfield Southfield on Friday night at 7:30. The winners of those games to meet at 7:30 on Saturday night. In the 1A brackets, at Bethany Christian, this is sectional 52. It'll be Fort Wayne Blackhawk Christian versus Elkhart Christian Academy on Tuesday night at 6 o'clock. And then at 7:30, it'll be Lakewood Park Christian versus Bethany Christian. On Friday night, it'll be Lakeland Christian Academy versus the winner of Blackhawk Christian and Elkhart Christian Academy. And then at 7:30 on Friday night, Hamilton will face the winner of Lakewood Park and Bethany Christian. And then on Saturday night, that will be the championship game at 7:30. And I'm sure there's a big crowd that will be there if Lakewood Park and Blackhawk Christian should happen to meet each other in that sectional championship game. That is your state roundup. We will go over that once again at halftime. We are live at Southside High School on SummitCitySports.com. We're going to take a quick timeout, and then we'll come back and preview this game between the visitors' New Haven Bulldogs and the Bishop Luers Knights.
This time we have us playing the singing of the school songs, the New Haven School Song Theater by the New Haven Chanters.
Welcome back to Bishop Luers High School for tonight's live high school basketball game on SummitCitySports.com between the visitors on the scoreboard, the New Haven Bulldogs, and the Bishop Luers Knights. New Haven comes into this game 18-6 overall on the season, 6-1 in the Northeast 8 Conference. They are the number 15th ranked team in 3A, and they are coached by Bruce Stevens. He's in his third year as the head coach at New Haven. He is 41-31. The Bulldogs average 64 points a game and only give up 57. Their last game was a win over Heritage where they won big, 57-35. They are on a three-game winning streak, and they will play their final game tomorrow night at Bluffton at 7:30. for Bishop Luers, they are a member of the Summit Athletic Conference. They come into this game 13-7 overall, 6-3 in conference play, number 4 ranked in 3A. They are coached by J.J. Foster. He's in his fourth year. He is 47-40. His team averages 64 points a game, and they hold teams to 58. Let's take a look at the standings first for the Summit Athletic Conference. The conference is all wrapped up. The Snyder Panthers wrapped up the conference championship. They have a 15-6 overall record, and they were 9-0 in conference play. Northside came in second in Summit Athletic Conference, 21-1 overall, 9-1 in conference play on a 15-game win streak, and they are the number one ranked team in the state of Indiana in 4A. Homestead comes in third. They had a conference mark of 7-2. They were 18-3 overall, and they are also on a big win streak of 7 games. Bishop Luers, their conference mark stands at 6-3, 13-7 overall, and they lost last week, Friday night, in what was just a great game out here at Bishop Luers to Northside. Checking in at number five is Carroll. They're 4-5 in conference play, 11-9 overall. Northrop is tied with Carroll in the conference at 4-6, 12-10 overall, and they're on a 3-game win streak. Fort Wayne Wayne, they check in next at 3-6, 9-11 overall. Well, you'll get to see Wayne tomorrow night right here on SummitCitySports.com. Bishop DeWinger checks in at number 7. They're 2-7, 10-10 overall. The Southside Archers check in at number 8. They're 2-7 as well, 5-13 overall, and they're looking to get back on the winning streak here shortly. Fort Wayne Concordia is 0-9 in conference play, 3-16 overall this season. The NE8 standings are as follows. In first place is the Huntington North team. They are 16-6, 7-0 in conference play. You'll see them Friday night here on Summit City Sports against Bishop Luers. New Haven checks in at number 2. They're 18-6 overall, 6-1 in conference. They're on a 3-game win streak. Columbia City sits in third place with 11-16 record, 5-3 in conference play. Norwell checks in at number 4 at 13-9, 5-3 in conference. While Leos is in fifth place, 11-14, 3-5 in conference. East Nobles in sixth place with an 11-9 mark, 2-5 in conference. DeKalb, they are 8-12, 2-5 in conference play, but they are presently on a 5-game winning streak. Belmont checks in eighth place in the NE8 at 4-17 overall and 0-7 in conference play. Well, Bishop Luers and New Haven met last year, and Bishop Luers was victorious 52-47 on February the 22nd, so almost 1 year to the date that these two teams played, and Luers prevailed. The series last 30 years, New Haven leads. They have a 7-5 mark over Bishop Luers. We're just about ready to get the starting lineups here at Bishop Luers High School. We will take a quick timeout, and we will be right back with the starting lineups here at Bishop Luers High School. You're watching High School Basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Welcome back to Bishop Luers High School for tonight's non-conference game between the visiting Bulldogs and the Bishop Luers Knights. Today's broadcast is brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Follow us on Twitter at 260Sports, like our Facebook page, Summit City Sports, and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Parkview Sports Medicine is a proud supporter of Fort Wayne Area Athletics and its athletes. Parkview Sports Medicine can provide the training, treatment, and education you need to advance your sports game. Have any questions about injury prevention, sports nutrition, and more? We've got you covered. That's Parkview Sports Medicine at parkview.com. Sports Center, Inc. is Fort Wayne's premier sporting goods dealer, offering equipment rental, embroidery, screen printing, And Sports Center is ready and willing to help you place orders or answer any questions concerning pricing. Sports Center, Inc. is located at 5511 Coventry Lane, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 468-04. SummitCitySports.com is proud to partner with the News Sentinel, Allen County's oldest continuous operating business, bringing you the most comprehensive high school athletic coverage in the area. The News Sentinel is available for delivery 6 times a week in Allen County, always online at NewsSentinel.com. Well, the starters are being announced right now for the Bulldogs. They got a quick change here before we get started.
And now for the Bishop Luers Knights.
For New Haven, they will start Atgar, a senior, number 2, Bricar Clark. At one guard, number 22, James Gardner. At center, Whitney Harris, the senior, number 5. At forward, number 24, Ivan Upshaw. He's a senior. And at the other forwards position, number 34, a senior, Joey Rowan. The starters for Bishop Luers. At one guard, at 5'11", senior, number 11, Ray Walker Jr. At the other guard position, also a senior and 5'11", number 12, J.J. Foster. At forward, a 6'5", senior, number 15, Blaine Cook. At the other forwards position, a senior at standing 6'3", number 5, Trey Underwood. And at the other forward position, a 6'5", senior, Anton Berry, number 25. We'll take a quick timeout. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Welcome back to Bishop Luers High School for our non-conference game on Summit City Sports tonight between New Haven and Bishop Luers. Jumping center is Anton Berry for Bishop Luers against Whitney Harris of the Bulldogs. Craig Hershey to throw the ball up, our official tonight, and he throws it up, and we are underway at Bishop Luers High School. Officials tonight, Craig Hershey, Trent Long, and Jake Linder. Trey Underwood to control it way outside. This should be a good matchup tonight between these two teams. Both teams very quick. Both teams look to get up and down the court as fast as possible and get some good scoring. Bishop Luers shoots the ball extremely well from three range. J.J. Foster, Ray Walker, and Blaine Cook, all legitimate weapons from deep. Whitney Harris will guard Blaine Cook way outside. He'll get it right baseline to Foster, who gets it into Anton Berry, who will go ahead and play college football next year at Marion. That shot's up and missed, but there's Barry. He gets it and throws it off of Whitney Harris, who was out of bounds. Out of bounds to Bishop Luers. New Haven, a very quick team. They also can shoot the ball pretty well from the outside. They got James Gardner and Ivan Upshaw and also Joey Rowan that can shoot the ball from deep. They play some good defense. This is a good high school matchup. Foster to inbounds for Luers. He's having a hard time finding an open guy. Now he'll find Cook all the way in the right baseline. They'll have a ball reversal. Now they'll get it inside to the really strong Trey Underwood. And he kicks it out to Anton Berry for three, and his first three-pointer is good. Foster against Garner. Garner will give the ball up now. He'll get it back, gets it down low to Harris. He'll right-handed jumper up and misses the hard off the backboard and picked up by Ray Walker Jr. Walker and Barry both transferred into this school from Northrop, while Foster came over from Homestead. So a lot of players that moved in here. There's a turnover against Bishop Luers. And New Haven will get the ball back. Picard Clark now to handle the ball against Ray Walker. He'll go behind the back and he's going to shoot a three. It's in and out and rebounded for the second time by J.J. Foster Jr. And Foster comes in this game averaging 12 points a game, two rebounds and four assists. Trey Underwood, he's got a strength advantage against Joey Rowan underneath. See if Luers tries to exploit that. Luers dressed in their home whites and New Haven in their purple, road purples tonight. Good screen there for Foster, but he gets caught way outside. And now they run a quick screen on top, give it to Barry. Barry now to Ray Walker, back to Foster, left side. He looks to get an angle. He'll get in the lane. He'll pull up. He's going to be called for a travel. So two early turnovers against Bishop Luers. Harris to inbounds. He'll hit Clark. Clark will turn around. He's guarded by Ray Walker. Now he give it up to Garner. Garner guarded by Foster. They'll go to Ivan Upshaw, now up to Joey Rowan. Rowan against Cook. Rowan, a good-looking shooter. He's left-handed. Clark now to Harris. He's guarded by Anton Berry. New Haven being real patient on offense right now. Bill, number 24, will shoot it, and he'll hit, and that's Ivan Upshaw with his first 3 points, and we're all tied up. Foster, right side, quickly moving first quarter here. No fouls on either team, only two turnovers. 5 minutes remains. We're all tied up at three here at Bishop Luers High School. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Foster, right side. Now he's going to look to get a high screen from Barry. He'll drive, kick it to Walker. He will not shoot the three. Now he'll kick it to Foster. Foster will find a wide open Cook on the left side. His three-pointer up and good. Cook with his first three, and that gives Luers a 3-point lead, 6-3 over New Haven. Clark, he'll spin into the lane, and he's cut off there, and he'll give it up to Garner. Garner will go around to Upshaw. Upshaw looks inside to Harris. He'll turn around and shoot about a 12-footer. It's off and rebounded by Ray Walker. Most of the rebounds in this game thus far have been by the guards. Clark will go in. He's actually hacked, and they won't call a foul, but he'll get the 2 points. So Clark with his first 2 points, and it's 6-5, Luers. Barry, he turns around. I'm surprised he didn't shoot that. Now they'll get it back to Cook. Cook really good from down on the baseline. Oh, Trey Underwood will shoot a three. It's hard off the backboard, rebounded by Ivan Upshaw. He looks to push. Nice bounce pass, but it's picked off by J.J. Foster. He'll find a wide open Ray Walker. He'll shoot, and he will score. Walker on the board with his first three, and the lead is now 4. Rowan looks to shoot. He jab steps. Now he'll pull it back out and give it up to Clark. Ray Walker doing a nice job on Bricard Clark. Rowan now, he'll go around the back. Between the legs, pop a three-pointer. He banks it in. and the lead back down to one. Well, the bank was open for Joey Rowan on that play. Trey Underwood, he'll get in the lane, actually travels, gets away with it, gives it up to Anton Berry, who will shoot it left-handed and score. So Berry with five, the lead back to three. Ooh, dangerous pass there by Clark over to Upshaw. Now he has a good angle down there to Whitney Harris. He'll turn around. He's got Trey Underwood on him. He ball fakes. Now he'll give it up to Ivan Upshaw. He'll go left, kick it back to Clark right. He'll shoot a long three-pointer. It's hard off the back of the rim, picked up by Ray Walker, and he'll find a wide-open Trey Underwood, and he'll travel. He was shocked how wide-open he was, I think. And he travels. 2:12 remains here at Bishop Luers High School in the first quarter. Bishop Luers leads 11-8 and into the game for Bishop Luers. Number three, Jason Davis for Trey Underwood. He's a pretty good player, ladies and gentlemen. He's long, he can shoot from the outside, and he's tough on with the rebounding, especially on the offensive end. Into the game for New Haven, number 30. That's DeMario Robinson. Ricard Clark, he'll handle the duties at point guard right now for New Haven. He'll get up to Robinson. Robinson guarded by Jason Davis. He'll try to get in the lane. He's cut off. It's Rowan. Three-pointer on the way, and it's an air ball. Air ball picked up by Anton Berry, and now the Luers looks to push. No numbers. He wisely picks up his dribble, and now they'll kick it to Berry. He'll shoot the three-pointer and hits another one. Berry with his second three-pointer, and the lead up to six. Garner will handle it left side right in front of the Luers bench. He'll kick it to Robinson, who comes off the bench, shoots a three. It's hard off the back, and that'll be out of bounds off of Garner, and Luers will have the ball. 1:26 remains with Bishop Luers leading 14-8 over New Haven. Into the game now will be Keyshawn Moore. He'll replace Picard Clark. Keyshawn Moore is a very fine football player himself. Like I said earlier, Anton Berry will not play college basketball. He will play college football at the University of Marion down in Indianapolis. University of Marion is a perennial power in the NAIA division. They've won two national championships in the last 5 years, and he will enjoy his time down there playing for a great team. I think that ball deflected off of... They call the ball out off of Bishop Luers. Actually, no, they'll switch it and say it was off of Whitney Harris. Berry to inbounds. He'll give it to Foster. Foster right back to Berry. He'll spin in the lane. He's hacked. They're going to call a foul there on number five, Whitney Harris from New Haven. That's the first foul of the game. His first, team's first. The foul was on the floor with 1:02 remaining here in the first quarter. Looks fine. Jason Davis, now he throws it away, but Ray Walker quickly over there to pick it up. He'll find a wide open Davis. Davis doesn't shoot it. He'll kick it to Walker. Now he'll look baseline. Nothing there. They'll whip the ball back around. Nice ball reversal there by Bishop Luers. Foster will shoot a three. It's off the front of the rim and rebounded by Harris. Robinson has it now for New Haven. 40 seconds remain. He'll drive on Davis. They'll call a block on Davis. His first, team's first. New Haven comes into this game 18-6 overall, 6-1 in conference play, and Jalen Causey will replace Blaine Cook, so Bishop Luers gets smaller with the Causey in the game. Luers comes into this game 13-7, 6-3 overall. They try to announce for a sub, but that can't go, and then Rowan will catch the ball and shoot and hit. He'll have his fifth point. Not sure if that clock or that whistle made the defense stop. That foul will be on Moore. Keyshawn Moore, his first, team second. Luers to inbounds. And now into the game, it looks like number two will come back in, Bricard Clark. Clark will replace Rowan. New Haven coached by Bruce Stevens. He is in his third year. A nice pass to Anton Berry. He'll catch it, and he will hit. So Berry with 10 points. And the Luers lead back to six. 25 seconds remains. Causey against Moore. Keyshawn Moore very quick with the ball. Nice, around his legs and up. He misses it, tipped up, it's missed. But Robinson picked up by Harris. He's fouled, the hack in the arm. And that foul will be on Jason Davis, his second, the team's second. And Harris will go to the line and shoot one. So Davis comes into the game and quickly picks up two fouls. Harris to shoot one. It's up hard off the backboard and picked up by Ray Walker. They'll push. We're 10 seconds remaining here in the first quarter at Bishop Luers High School, where the Knights lead the Bulldogs 16-12. He's got an open shot from 16, and he'll take it and hit it. So Ray Walker Jr. hits, and that's his fifth point. That's the end of the third quarter. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. We're back live at Bishop Luers High School, where the Luers Knights lead the Bulldogs 18-12. We're getting ready to start the second quarter. Today's broadcast is brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Follow us on Twitter at 260Sports and like our Facebook page, Summit City Sports. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Parkview Sports Medicine is a proud supporter of Fort Wayne Area Athletics and its athletes. Parkview Sports Medicine can provide the training, treatment, and education you need to advance your sports game. Have any questions about injury prevention, sports nutrition, and more? We've got you covered. That's Parkview Sports Medicine at parkview.com. They'll quickly get the ball into Robinson. He'll turn and shoot about a 12-footer and hit it. DeMario Robinson with his first two, and the lead cut to four. Davis, Causey, Cook, Underwood, and Foster for Bishop Luers. Clark, Robinson, Bricard Clark, Keyshawn Moore, and number 10 who checked in, Mitchell, on the court. Clark with his first foul. Team's third. Ray Walker Jr., he'll come back in and replace Jason Davis. Trey Underwood will not shoot this three-pointer this time. They'll go right baseline to Foster. He'll kick it out to Ray Walker. He's going to back it out. He's guarded there by Garner. Now to Foster, guarded by Clark. Gets it underneath, and that foul will be on Mitchell, who just checked in the game. Mitchell's first, team's fourth. 7-18 remains here in the first half, with the Luers leading 18-14 over New Haven. Causey will check out, and back into the game quickly for Bishop Luers, Anton Berry. Good look to Barry. Now look to get it right inside to Trey Underwood. Now he'll kick it left baseline to Cook. His three-pointer's off and rebounded by Mitchell. He'll give it to Moore. Moore now will look to push. Moore, a very good football player in his own right. He's a quarterback slash running back slash do everything for New Haven's football team. They'll reset. Moore resets, trailing by four. Moore will shoot a three-pointer and hit it. One-point game once again here at Bishop Luers. Ray Walker now, he'll control out front. He looks for Foster right side. New Haven switches into a 3-2 zone. They'll look high-low. Nice pass underneath to Anton Bear. Blocked by Mitchell. And now Clark will push. He's got one man to beat. He does. He scores. And Clark with his fourth point, and New Haven leads. Quickly up the court to Anton Berry, but they call a foul. New Haven leads by one now, 19-18. That foul was on New Haven's number 22, James Garner. His first, team's fifth, at the line shooting. Two, Anton Berry. He hits the first one and we're all tied up. Berry with 11. Trey Underwood will check out and Jalen Causey to return. Berry to shoot a second one. That's his 12th. And Luers leads by one. Moore against Causey. Got to make Moore go left if you want to be effective against him. Gardner against Foster. He'll jump shoot. He'll miss, get his own rebound, and then he's fouled. On the foul is on Foster. He forgot to block out Gardner. Third foul on the Luers team. Foster's first, team's third. Moore to inbounds. He'll hit Clark. He'll turn around, shoot a three, and hit it. Clark with his seventh point, and New Haven has a two-point lead. 5:40 remains. We got an official timeout. We've got a part of the volleyball court. One of the caps has come up. Got an official timeout here at Luers High School with New Haven leading 22-20 over the home team, Bishop Luers. Foster finds, that's Causey. Oh, he's got a cutter right there. Turns around, Anton Berry shoots a 15-footer, and nothing but net. Once again, we're all tied up. Berry with his 14th point. Moore way outside against Causey. Bruce Stevens calling out the new set he wants on offense. Moore looks down low. He'll find Gardner against a smaller J.J. Foster. He'll go up. He'll miss. And Foster loses it, gives it up to Robinson, and Robinson will hit. And there's a turnover on Bishop Luers, their fourth turnover. New Haven leads 24-22 with an even 5 minutes remaining here in the first half. The halftime will go over quickly, some scoring, and we will update you on the state tournament brackets. Moore against Causey, he's cut off. Now he'll back it back out, almost all the way to center. Clark has it. Clark and Keyshawn Moore, they're a very good tandem at guard. Moore now, he'll give it up to Robinson. Robinson shoots a three, it's hard off the backboard. Goes long, picked up by Gardner. He'll find Clark wide open for three. It's hard off the backboard and rebounded by Anton Berry. Luers pushes up to Causey. Now to Cook. Cook finds Berry. He turns around for a 13-footer and hits it. We're all tied up again. Our scoreboard operator's putting the points in the fouls department. Berry with 16 first half points. Nice defense. Turnover by Luers. They'll look to push. Ray Walker looks underneath, finds Foster, who couldn't believe the ball actually made it to him, and then Berry picks it up. He misses, gets his own rebound, and hits. Berry with 18, and Bruce Stevens has seen enough, and he will call a timeout. With a timeout on the court, we will take a timeout here at Bishop Luers High School. You are watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Welcome back to the Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers leads New Haven by two with 3:46 remaining here in the first half. Joey Rowan back into the game for New Haven. He'll be guarded by Blaine Cook. They'll find Robinson right baseline. He's guarded by Berry, now to Rowan. Rowan will pull back, shoot a three, it's hard off, rebounded by Berry, then he turns it over, and they'll call that on Ivan Upshaw. On Upshaw, that will be his first. The team's sixth. Ray Walker way out top against Ricard Clark. They're going to go into a trap. New Haven is. Causey will shoot it. It's a long rebound to Anton Berry. Now Causey will shoot another three. It'll go in and out. And it's tipped around and picked up by Blaine Cook. He'll go underneath to Trey Underwood, who is fouled by Joey Rowan. That'll be Rowan's first, the team's seventh. So Trey Underwood will shoot the bonus. Underwood to shoot. His first one's up and hard off the backboard and rebounded by Robinson for New Haven. They find Clark. Clark looks underneath for Harris. Nothing there. Now he's got a lane. He'll drive. He's bumped on the hip by Ray Walker Jr. and he will shoot too. Clark will shoot two for New Haven, who trails. His first one's off the front of the rim. Foster, he'll return to the lineup for the Knights. He'll replace Jalen Causey. .247 remains here in the first half with Bishop Luers leading 26-25. Clark hits once again. 1 point game. Berry, he'll stop. He'll find Foster. He'll shoot it from the right wing. It's off. Rebounded. No, deflected by the Luers player, but I think they're going to call Trey Underwood with a push. Underwood's first, team's fourth. If you ever have scores and want to get them out to us, please include us in your tweets of the score updates at 260Sports on Twitter. Good defense by Bishop Luers, Anton Berry, and Ray Walker on Robinson. But Robinson turns around, dribbles it right off of Berry's foot. And New Haven will control, trailing by one. Rowan has it now. He'll give it up to Robinson. Oh, good defense there by Foster. Now we're going to have another loose ball that's picked up by Ray Walker. Walker right baseline to Cook. Cook back up to Walker. There's a three-pointer on the way by Foster, and it's good. Luers back in the lead by four. Robinson, a lot of dribbling out there. He'll find Harris underneath. Harris will turn around and spot up. Now he'll shoot about a 14-footer. It's very little arch and off the side of the rim. And Luers controls with 1:40 remaining here in the first half. Cook wide open left side. He'll shoot a three, and it's good. Cook's second three-pointer. They got Rowan trapped over there. We'll have a timeout on the court. We'll take a timeout here at Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers leads 32-25 over New Haven. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. New Haven to inbounds with 1:25 remaining on the clock here in the first half. They trail by 7 to Luers, 32-25. Sports Center Inc. is Fort Wayne's premier sporting goods dealer, offering equipment rental, embroidery and screen printing, Sports Center is ready and willing to help you place orders or answer any questions concerning pricing. Sports Center Inc. is located at 5511 Coventry Lane, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 46804. That foul's on number five, Whitney Harris, his second, team's eighth. Causey at the line will be actually Foster shooting 1-1 for Bishop Luers. Foster comes into this game averaging 12 points a game, 2 rebounds and 4 assists. His first one up and good. His fourth point. Cedric Mitchell enters the game for New Haven. For Whitney Harris, who will check out with those two fouls. 109 remains with Bishop Luers leading 33-25. Blaine Cook, he'll return if he makes a shot. It's up and good. I know they take him away from there, so we got 109 remaining. Clock hasn't started. Now it starts. At halftime, we'll have a sectional update for you. Of all the sectional games in the area, there's Garner. He'll shoot three, and he'll hit it. So James Garner on the board with his first three. New Haven needed that. They trail by six, and quickly Ray Walker Jr. left baseline. He shoots a three and hits it. Ray Walker Jr. with his eighth point. And now New Haven looks to push. Garner again from the left baseline. Well, Foster looks underneath for Trey Underwood, but it's deflected out of bounds. Blaine Cook replaced Trey Underwood. We've got 31 seconds remaining with Luers leading 37-21 over New Haven. Foster to inbounds. You have to watch Foster on the inbounds because once he inbounds it, he usually comes off a screen. Said he'll go right all the way around to Ray Walker, or that's Causey. He'll throw it away. That's the fifth turnover on Luers. New Haven inbounds. They could use a three-pointer here and cut this lead to maybe three at halftime. See if they play for one or if they will take the best shot available. More against Causey. 10 seconds. Now they'll go to the hot streaking James Garner. He'll find a wide open Ivan Upshaw. He'll through the three. It goes in and out. Deflected around. Picked up by Causey. And that is how we will end the first half with Bishop Luers 37, New Haven 31. We will take a quick timeout. We'll be back with some scoring, and we will give you the brackets for the state tournament for boys basketball in the state of Indiana. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com.
The 2016-2017 issue of Hoosier Basketball Magazine is on sale here tonight. This 256-page publication is a comprehensive survey of all high school, college, and pro basketball in Indiana. Bishop Luers is featured on page 65, including the photo of All-Stater J.J. Foster. New Haven is also spotlighted on page 65 with pictures of J.C. Gardner and Diane Tanners.
Welcome back to Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers leads New Haven 37-31. I'm Ryan Dellinger, and I'm going to give you the brackets for the state basketball tournament in boys basketball. First, at the Carroll Sectional. This is sectional number 5. In game 1 will be Fort Wayne Northside versus DeKalb at 6 p.m. on next Tuesday. That game will be followed by East Noble versus Carroll on Tuesday night. And then on Friday night, New Haven will await the winner of Northside DeKalb. And then following that game at 7:30, it will be the winner of East Noble Carroll against Snyder. And then on Saturday night at 7 p.m., the winners of those two semifinal games will compete for the championship. At the Wayne Sectional, that is Sectional 6. It will be Muncie Central versus Jay County on Tuesday at 6 p.m. They will be followed by Southside versus Homestead at 7:30. Huntington North will play the winner of the Muncie Central Jay County game Friday night at 6. Fort Wayne. Wayne will play the winner of Southside Homestead at 7:30 on Friday night. The winners of those games will meet in the championship at 7 p.m. on Saturday night at Wayne High School. In 3A, at Garrett. In game one on Tuesday night, it will be Leo and DeWanger at 6 o'clock. And then that game will be followed by Concordia versus Angola. New Haven will play the winner of Leo DeWanger on Friday night at 6. Garrett will await the winner of Concordia and Angola at 7 o'clock on Friday night, and the winners to meet at 7:30 at Garrett for the Sectional 22 championship game. At the Belmont Sectional, that'll be Sectional 23. The first game on Tuesday night will be Mississinewa versus Heritage. They will play at 6. They will be followed by Belmont and Columbia City at 7:30 on Tuesday night. On Friday night at 6, Luers will await the winner of Mississinewa Heritage, while Norwell will play the winner of Belmont Columbia City. The winners of those games will meet Saturday night at 7:30 at Belmont High School. That is the 3A basketball sectional roundup thus far. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back with 2A and 1A. We are live at Bishop Luers High School for this non-conference games where Bishop Luers leads 37-31 over New Haven. You're watching high school basketball on SummitCitySports.com. Welcome back to Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers leads 37-31 over the visiting Bulldogs of New Haven. We're previewing the state tournament in high school basketball right now, and we're going to resume with the 2A sectional roundup. This is sectional 36 from Woodland High School. In the first game on Tuesday night, it will be Cherubusco versus South Adams at 7 p.m. That is the only game on Tuesday night. On Wednesday night, it will be Bluffton versus Canterbury at 6 p.m. That game will be followed by Adams Central and Eastside at 7:30. On Friday night, the winner of Cherubusco South Adams will play Woodland, and the winners between Bluffton and Canterbury and Adams Central and Eastside will compete in the other semifinal. The championship game to be played on Saturday night at 7 o'clock. In the other 2A sectional, and that sectional is 37 at Oak Hill. The Oak Hill sectional. Cass will play Rochester on Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Wabash and Oak Hill will play on Wednesday night at 6 p.m. That game will be followed by Northfield and Southwood at 7:30. In the semifinals, Rochester will play the winner of Cass Manchester, and the winners of Wabash, Oak Hill, and Northfield Southwood will play each other in that semifinal on Friday night at 7:30. The championship game will be Saturday night at 7:30 at Oak Hill. And the 1A sectional, this will be sectional 52, and that will be at Bethany Christian High School in Goshen, Indiana. This is sectional 52. The first game on Tuesday night will be Fort Wayne Blackhawk Christian versus Elkhart Christian Academy. They will be followed by Lakewood Park and Bethany Christian at 7:30. The semifinals will have Lakeland Christian Academy versus the winner of Blackhawk and Elkhart, and Hamilton will play the winner of Lakewood Park and Bethany Christian at 7:30 on Friday night. And then the championship game will be Saturday night at 7:30 at Bethany Christian in Goshen. That does it for the sectional roundup from here at Bishop Luers High School. Remember, tomorrow night we'll be back on here again when we do the game live from Wayne High School. We will take a quick timeout here. We'll come back and we will give you the scoring update in this game between Bishop Luers and New Haven. You are watching high school basketball, live high school basketball, on SummitCitySports.com. The teams have returned to the court here at Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers leads New Haven 37-31. SummitCitySports.com is proud to partner with the New Sentinel, Allen County's oldest continuously operating business, bringing you the most comprehensive high school athletic coverage in the area. The New Sentinel is available for delivery 6 times a week in Allen County and always online at thenewsentinel.com. Well, here's the scoring for these two teams. First for New Haven, Bricard Clark has 7. Actually, he has 8. Keyshawn Moore with 3. James Gardner with 6. Ivan Upshaw with 3. Demario Robinson with 4. And Joey Rowan with 5. For Bishop Luers, Ray Walker Jr. has 8. J.J. Foster has 4. Blaine Cook with 2 three-pointers. He has 6. And leading all scorers here at halftime, Anton Berry with 18. Well, where do these two teams go from here? Short turnaround for New Haven. They will play tomorrow night at Bluffton at 7:30, while Bishop Luers will be off until Friday night, where they will host Huntington North at 7:30, a game you can see right here on SummitCitySports.com. That game will be at 7:30. That will be senior night at Bishop Luers High School. We'll take a quick timeout. We'll be back with live action on SummitCitySports.com. We are back live at Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers will inbounds the ball here to start the second half. On the court, they'll have Ray Walker, Anton Berry, Blaine Cook, J.J. Foster, and Trey Underwood. Tonight's officials are Craig Hershey, Trent Long, and Jake Linder. On the court for New Haven, it's Clark, Harris, Rowan, Garner, and Upshaw. Good defense there by Whitney Harris, and he'll deflect the ball off of Anton Berry out of bounds. And New Haven will get the ball. That's a 6th turnover on Bishop Luers tonight. New Haven with just 2. Three-pointer on the way, off by Upshaw, and rebounded by Foster Jr., and that is his 4th rebound of this game. Ray Walker thinks about it, and then he'll give it up to Trey Underwood. They'll kick it around to Blaine Cook. Cook, who's already hit 2 three-pointers, and now 16-footer on the way by Underwood, which really isn't his game, and tipped out and controlled by Clark by New Haven. Clark in the lane. He's fouled. If it goes, it'll count. It won't. That foul will be on number 15, Blaine Cook. His first, the team's first, and at the line shooting 2 will be Clark. Clark in the first half, he was hot. He had 8 points for New Haven. They trail by 6 with 7:13 remaining at Bishop Luers High School. Nice crowd tonight for a Monday night game. Clark's first one up and good. Clark got the start tonight over the normal point guard, Keyshawn Moore. Bruce Stevens, the head coach of New Haven, he's in his third year at 41-31. Second one up and good. Foster looks underneath, nothing there. Good spacing that time by Luers, but they turn it over. Barry was trying to find Cook underneath and threw it away. Rowan way outside, he'll give it to Garner. Garner inside to Harris. Harris turns around, he'll get in the lane, pump fake, goes up and scores. That's where Whitney Harris needs to be, is underneath, not way outside. A guy with that much size should not be playing that far away from the basket. Walker now, he's guarded by Garner. He'll go left and give it up to Foster. You got to get out and close out on him. Clark does. But then that's a turnover. Garner will go in. Oh, that's a nasty looking fall, but he'll hit the bucket. Garner hits the bucket. And we're all tied up. Three-pointer on the way. It's missed. Deflected out to Foster. He'll kick it all the way to the right side. Ray Walker Jr.'s three's on the way. And that's an air ball. Good block out by Harris. And now New Haven can look to take the lead. Harris gets in there, he wisely backs it out. Rowan will shoot the three, left-hander on the way. It's good. And all at once, New Haven has caught fire. New Haven on a 9-0 run to start the second half. That foul will be on the floor against Clark. His second, team's first. 9-0 run by New Haven to start this half. And into the game, Jason Davis will come in. A little more length inside the gear, and he'll take the place of Trey Underwood. Foster, he'll get it into Anton Berry. Now they'll swing it. Now here comes that pick that comes back. Good underneath post position by Anton Berry. He can't hit the turnaround, and Whitney Harris with a good rebound. And New Haven looks to extend their lead. Be interesting if New Haven scores here. Coach Foster will take a timeout. There's a push on Ray Walker Jr., his second, the team's second. Walker's third, actually. Upshaw inbounds, he'll give it up to Harris. Causey will come back in, sure, for Ray Walker, who's got three fouls. Garner will back in on Foster. Kicks it to Rowan. Rowan almost turns it over. Davis was right there and missed it. Offensive rebound, New Haven, by Ivan Upshaw, and he can't hit it. Now Foster looks to push. He'll stop and pop a three. Oh, hard off the back of the rim and rebounded by Garner. 4:42 remains. Rowan will shoot another three. He'll miss it. Ball's picked up by Ray Walker Jr. He looks up. Now he'll look to push, really no numbers. He'll get in the lane, his left-handed shot, up and hard off the backboard, rebounded by Harris. He'll give it up to Clark, and New Haven will have the ball once again, leading by three over Bishop Luers. Clark will stop and pop a three. It's in and out, and Foster will come up with another rebound. And that'll be a foul on Harris. Whitney Harris will pick up his third, and at the line shooting two will be Anton Berry. Today's broadcast is brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Follow us on Twitter at 260Sports. Like our Facebook page, Summit City Sports. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Parkview Sports Medicine is a proud supporter of Fort Wayne Area Athletics and its athletes. Parkview Sports Medicine can provide the training, treatment, and education you need to advance your sports game. Have any questions about injury prevention, sports nutrition, and more? We've got you covered. That's Parkview Sports Medicine at parkview.com. Barry misses his first. Into the game, Causey. He replaces Ray Walker Jr., who will sit with three fouls. 4:25 remains, and the lead still remains three for New Haven. Now Luers will go into a press. They're in a one-two. Oh, there's a good pass around by Rowan. It looked like they were in maybe a 1-3-1 press. Harris inside, hard off the backboard. And Davis has it. Fozzie, he'll get it. He travels. Eighth turnover on Bishop Luers. It's a 2-2-1 press now by Bishop Luers. With Cook in the back, Davis and Anton Berry in the middle, and up front will be Causey and Foster. Rowan has it. He'll drive. He'll get in the lane. He's got to give it up to Harris. Harris will run right over Anton Berry, and they'll call that foul on Berry. His first, team's third. Garnered inbounds for New Haven. Couple subs here for New Haven. Looks like Harris will check out with his three fouls. Mitchell will replace him. Demario Robinson will take Joey Roan's spot. So Clark, Upshaw, Robinson, Garner, and Clark on the floor for New Haven. Robinson way out top. Luers in kind of a 3-2 matchup. And now they switch into a straight man. They kick it left side to Robinson. His three-pointer is going to be hard off the rim. Rebounded in there by Ivan Upshaw, a really good football player. He plays defensive back at New Haven. Now he'll shoot a three off his offensive rebound. Tipped up and in by Robinson. There's a timeout on the court. New Haven takes a five-point lead on Robinson's tip-in. And the Knights will call a timeout on the court. We'll take a timeout. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Welcome back to Bishop Luers High School, where New Haven comes out of halftime on fire. They're on an 11-0 run to start the second half. We've got 3:18 remaining here in the third quarter. They lead 42-37 over the number four ranked team in 3A, the Bishop Luers Knights. Davis to inbounds. He'll give it up to Foster. He's guarded by Moore, who checked in the last time out. Moore replaces Upshaw. Causey to Foster. Now New Haven, they're in a 2-3 zone. Berry will get it inside. He's hit on the wrist by Mitchell. That will be the second on Mitchell, the third on the team, and Anton Berry will shoot two. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Parkview Sports Medicine, Sports Center, Inc., and the New Sentinel. 2:59 here in the third quarter. Anton Berry will shoot two. His first one up, goes in. That's the first points in the second half for Bishop Luers, and his 19th. Berry to shoot the second one. It's up and in. Berry with his 20th point, and the lead back down to three. New Haven, nice and smooth against that zone. That press of Bishop Luers, with all the guards that New Haven has on the court, it's pretty easy for them to do that. And there's Garner in the lane, and he will hit. Garner with a little floater in the lane gets the lead back up to five for New Haven. Davis against Clark. He'll give it up to Berry. He turns around. No cutters there. He'll hit Cook left baseline. His three-pointer is good. That's his third. And maybe Luers has some life now. They only trail by two. They're just one good possession and a stop away from being either tied up or with the lead. Moore, he'll control now for New Haven. Bruce Stevens calling out the set he wants. Robinson, right side, guarded by Causey. He'll drive in. He'll reverse. Give it to Mitchell. He loses control, and it's hard off the backboard. Picked up by Anton Berry, and now Foster for Bishop Luers will kick it up to Causey. He'll shoot a three. And that's going to be hard. Picked up by Davis. He catches it and he scores. And we are all tied up. So now Luers on a little bit of a run. Moore gives it up to Robinson. He'll fake a pass and then hit a three. Demario Robinson with his seventh point, and New Haven leads once again by three. Davis, he'll have it way out top. He is a threat to shoot from downtown. Foster now, he'll drive baseline on Clark. He gets bumped. No call. Berry comes up with the rebound and finds Davis left side. He'll reset to Causey. Causey now to Cook. Round to Foster. He'll shoot the three, and it's good. Foster with his seventh, and we are tied once again. New Haven, the number 15th ranked team in 3A. Tied up here in the third quarter with the number 4 ranked team in 3A, Bishop Luers. We are under a minute. Moore will get way out there. He's got to be careful about not going over and back. He'll drive in against the shorter player. Mitchell gets away with a travel, and he will score. Foster backs it out. We've got 28 seconds. Foster against Clark. 20 seconds remains. Foster, he'll drive. He'll get right to the top of the key, and he'll stop. Back it back out. And now he's going to dribble, just dribble, dribble, dribble. He'll look, he'll kick it to Anton Berry, who fakes it, shoots the three. It goes hard off the backboard. Robinson will get it. He'll lose it. It's picked up by Mitchell. Now he'll shoot a three-pointer, and it is no good. We are at the end of three, where New Haven leads 49-47 here at Bishop Luers High School. We will take a timeout. We will be back with live high school basketball on SummitCitySports.com. We are back live at Bishop Luers High School, where New Haven comes out on fire in the second half. They went an 11-0 run, and they've been able to keep it up. And they lead Bishop Luers 49-47 to begin the fourth quarter at Luers High School. Craig Hershey will hand the ball to Keyshawn Moore to get this fourth quarter started. Our officials once again, Craig Hershey, Trent Long, and Jake Linder. Robinson has it. He's a streaky shooter from the outside. And now Luers will go into a, looks like they are in man at this point. Yes, they're in a trap. They're in a trapping 2-3 defense. Robinson will shoot from the right baseline. It's hard. Picked up by Cook, and now Ray Walker checks back in. He has three fouls. He'll push. He'll stop. Find Cook. Left side. Now to Davis. Left baseline. Looks underneath. Nothing there. He's got to get it underneath the Berry. He's got a big size advantage against Mitchell. Cook, Luers hasn't had the right angle to get the ball down there yet. Foster will shoot about a 20-footer and hit it. Foster hits his third three. Luers back in the lead by one. Now another long three-pointer by Clark. It's off, rebounded by Berry. Ray Walker has it, goes right through his hands and out of bounds. Another turnover on Bishop Luers. Into the game for New Haven, Whitney Harris, Ivan Upshaw, and Joey Rowan return for New Haven. So you got Rowan, Clark, Moore, Upshaw, and Harris for New Haven. Rowan to inbounds. He looks. Now he finds Harris. Harris turns around, gives it up to Moore. Moore gets in the lane, stop, jump stop, goes up and score. And New Haven once again in the lead by one. Foster, he's going to back it out. He'll reset. Assistant coach Vernon Johnson helping him get the offense set for Bishop Luers. They back off. He shoots a three, and he hits again. Foster with his forced three-pointer, and the Luers lead back to two. Good look up the court by New Haven. Joey Rowan will shoot a three. That's probably ill-advised, and I don't think Bruce Stevens will like that shot because Rowan had a wide-open Whitney Harris under the basket. Foster's feeling it. He'll shoot. Looks like a little bit like Isaiah Thomas yesterday and Russell Westbrook there. Rowan gets away with a push after Blaine Cook shoots it. And Luers, shortest guy on the court, Foster comes up with another rebound. We're under 6 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter from Bishop Luers High School. A fast-paced moving game. We started a little bit late, and we are moving quick. Ray Walker against Ivan Upshaw. He'll go left side to Foster, drives in the lane, and he's bumped there by Moore. That'll be Moore's second, the team's fourth. And Luers will inbounds under their own basket, leading by two. Jason Davis now, he'll look to ball reversal. They don't get it, so they'll give it back to the left side to Ray Walker. He's guarded by Gardner. He's really not been able to shoot over the taller Gardner for New Haven tonight. Walker to Cook. Not a lot of movement right now by the Bishop Luers team. And now Foster will get the ball and reset the offense. 5:22 remains with Luers leading by two, 53-51. Now he'll find Berry in just a little pick and give, and he misses. Berry, who was hot in the first half, has only had 2 points here in the second half. Good look inside to Whitney Harrison. He'll hit. More to Harris. And once again, we are all tied up with 5 minutes to go. Neither team really in foul trouble, so they may have to use some of them in the end. And now Harris will back off of Foster, and he will drain another three-pointer. His fifth. Whitney Harris has got to know you cannot back off of their guards. Joey Rowan now, he'll have it. He'll find Moore. Now Moore will reset. I think he was going to shoot it if he had caught it cleanly. Jason Davis, a really tall, long player guarding him. Got about a 6'6" guy out there against about a 5'10". And Davis picks his pocket, and he'll push. He'll go to the rim. He'll throw it up, and he's fouled by Ivan Upshaw. Upshaw's second, team's fourth. Jason Davis now to shoot two for Bishop Luers, who lead by three with 4:20 remaining here in the game. Once again, New Haven will be in action tomorrow night where they will play Bluffton at 7:30. Bishop Luers, on the other hand, they'll wait to play Friday night on senior night here at Bishop Luers. They will play Huntington North, the NEA conference leaders. That's at 7-0. They'll play them right here at 7:30 on Friday night. Davis's first one in and out. He'll shoot his second one. It's up and good. Jason Davis with his third point. And the lead extends to four for Bishop Luers. So both teams have had their runs here in the second half. Who will be able to stop the other one? There's another turnover. Look out. Jason Davis right to the rim. He looked to get hit instead of going up strong. And now New Haven pushes. Gardner, he'll turn around, gets away with a double dribble, finds Rowan, three-pointer on the way, in and out, and rebounded by Jason Davis. He'll give it up to the guard, Ray Walker. Rowan's ball was almost all the way down. So Davis with some real good minutes here in the second half and some great rebounding. Foster against Moore. Moore cannot back off of him. Here's a little screen. And now it's the taller Harris guarding him. Now they back off again, and Foster hits another three. We've got a timeout on the court. Foster with 20 points. We've got a full timeout on the court. We'll take a timeout. You're watching high school basketball, brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Yeah. We're back live at New Haven, or at Bishop Luers High School, where Luers has gone on a run, thanks in part to J.J. Foster Jr., who has hit 6 3-pointers in this game. Quick turnover there by New Haven gives the ball right back to Bishop Luers, who leads by 7 with 3 minutes remaining here in the game. Good look again to Foster. He'll stop. They back off again, and he shoots another 3 and hits it. Well, I'm not sure what they told the guys in the New Haven timeout, but obviously number 12 is the guy you want to find, and there will be another timeout by New Haven. There was a trap, and we've got a 30-second timeout here on the court. We'll stay right here at Bishop Luers High School. Parkview Sports Medicine is a proud supporter of Fort Wayne Area Athletics and its athletes. Parkview Sports Medicine can provide the training, treatment, and education you need to advance your sports game. Have any questions about injury prevention, sports nutrition, and more? We've got you covered. That's Parkview Sports Medicine at parkview.com. Sports Center, Inc. is Fort Wayne's premier sporting goods dealer, offering equipment rental, embroidery, and screen printing. Sports Center is ready and willing to help you place orders or answer any questions concerning pricing. Sports Center, Inc. is located at 5511 Coventry Lane, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 46804. SummitCitySports.com is proud to partner with the New Sentinel, Allen County's oldest continuously operating business, bringing you the most comprehensive high school athletic coverage in the area. The New Sentinel is available for delivery 6 times a week in Allen County and always online at newsentinel.com. Today's broadcast is brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Follow us on Twitter at 260Sports. Like our Facebook page, Summit City Sports, and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, if you have scores and you want to get them to us, you can get them to us at 260Sports on Twitter, or you can send them to me at Rhino71, that's R-H-I-N-O-O-7-1 on Twitter. The ball goes in and out. It's a 10-point lead now by Bishop Luers. The clock is now on their side. Will they look to continue to move the ball quickly, or will they take some time off the clock right here? Nice look underneath. Robinson plays some good defense. He'll deflect it out. They had a set play there for J.J. Foster Jr., and why not? The young man has already hit 7 3-pointers. He has 23 points to lead all scorers in this game. There'll be a foul on Harris. That will be his 4th. The team's 6th. So New Haven did have to use up a foul, but I'm not sure Whitney Harris is a guy they would want to have out of the game. So Harris with his fourth. 2:24 remains. Bishop Luers leads by 10, 63-53 over New Haven. Bishop Luers at their season average right now. Foster against Garner. He'll pick it up. Good deflection there away by Robinson. Garner picks it up, and then he'll be fouled by Ray Walker Jr., who's picked up his 4th foul. The team's 4th. 2:11 remains. Can New Haven get some good offensive sets here and get back into this game? Looks like Ray Walker will probably check out here for Jason Davis. So Davis replaces Walker. This will probably be a little defense for offense for the rest of the game for Coach Foster. Robinson to inbounds. He can't move. He'll throw it into the backcourt to Garner. He'll pick it up now, and he'll come into the front court. They'll go right side to Upshaw. They'll look for a skip pass. Wisely doesn't do it. Clark will shoot about a 23-footer. It's hard off the rim. Whitney Harris goes over the back and tries to tip it in. Nothing there, and we're under 2. Bishop Luers leads by 10, 63-53. Foster drive on Clark. And he'll get called for a travel. The 10th turnover now for Bishop Luers. Remember, next week, it will be sectional time in the state of Indiana in high school basketball for the boys. Check out the ISHA website to find out where your favorite team is playing, and SummitCitySports.com to see where our games will be at and the schedule there. Harris will score 2. 1:20 remains. Timeout on the court. Bishop Luers. We'll see if it's a full or a 30-second. It's a full timeout. We'll take a full timeout here at Bishop Luers High School. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. We're back live at Bishop Luers High School on SummitCitySports.com, where Bishop Luers leads New Haven 63-55 with 1:22 remaining here in the game. We're out of the timeout where Ray Walker will inbounds for Bishop Luers. He'll look to get it in. He looks for Barry. Now he'll try to get it to him. And there's Robinson. It will travel on Barry that wasn't called. Walker up now. They're looking to trap him. And now there'll be a foul on Clark of New Haven. That's Clark's third. The team's seventh. So in the bonus now will be Bishop Luers. Ray Walker Jr. to shoot. Want to thank our sponsors once again tonight, Summit City Sports, Parkview Sports Medicine, Sports Center, Inc., and the News Sentinel. Walker's first one up and good. Walker with his ninth point. And the lead back to nine. New Haven came out in the second half and started an 11-0 run. Looked like they were going to gain control of the game, but then they forgot to guard number 12, J.J. Foster, and he goes crazy in the second half with 5 3-pointers, and he brings Luers back, and now they are in control, and they lead by 10. Upshaw in the lane, he'll drive right to the bucket, and he'll hit it. New Haven can't use their timeouts because they only have one left. Lead back down to 8, they'll try and trap Foster. Clark on Foster, he's gotta get across the timeline, and we'll have a timeout, a 30-second timeout on the court by J.J. Foster, the head coach of Bishop Luers. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're watching high school basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. .2 seconds remains here at Bishop Luers High School, where the Luers Knights lead 65-57 over New Haven. New Haven will be in action tomorrow night at Bluffton, where they will play at 7:30. Luers will be off until Friday night, where they will play Huntington North right here on senior night. Davis gets the ball quickly up the court to Ray Walker Jr. He streaks to the basket and hits it. That'll pretty much probably put this game out of reach, unless New Haven can come up with a miracle. And there's a turnover, and that will really hurt right there. And now they'll have to foul, and that's Clark. He'll foul Foster. That'll be his third, team's eighth, and Foster will be at the line. The player of the night tonight, especially in the second half, will be J.J. Foster. He has 23 points. Anton Berry has 21, and Ray Walker with 12 so far. Out of the game will come Clark. Into the game will be number 3, Latham. A lot of subs coming in now. I'm not sure I even have numbers for these guys that are coming into the game for New Haven.
Number 40. Number 20, Davion Harris.
Number 20, Davion Harris.
Donovan Lewis.
Donovan Lewis checks in as well. Some JV players getting some action. So Foster will shoot here once again. He'll shoot his first one up and good. Foster with his 24th point. The lead now 11. We've only got 30.2 seconds remaining. Some of the crowd's starting to file out of Bishop Luers High School. Foster's second one up and good. 12-point lead, 29 seconds remain, and some JV players now will bring it up for New Haven. They'll get it inside. Number 20 will score two. That is, let's see here. Let me check that. That is Contrell Thomas. Contrell Thomas. And they'll just dribble it out. Ray Walker Jr. will. And that's how the game will end with 69-59. Bishop Luers. We will take about a 2-minute timeout. We'll come back with the final scoring. And that will do it here at Bishop Luers High School. So we'll take about a 60-second timeout. We'll come back with all the scoring and recap the game for you. You're watching High School Basketball brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Welcome back to Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers is victorious over New Haven tonight, 69-59. We'll have a quick scoring update for you now. First for New Haven. Their scoring is as follows. Ricard Clark has 9. Keyshawn Moore with 5. Whitney Harris with 6. Control Mitchell off the bench with 2. Leading all scorers for New Haven, James Garner with 10. Ivan Upshaw with 5. Demario Robinson with 7. Joey Rowan with 8. New Haven falls this season to 18-7 overall. They will play tomorrow night at Bluffton at 7:30. And for Bishop Luers, Jason Davis with 3. Ray Walker Jr. with 12. J.J. Foster will lead all scorers tonight with 25. Blaine Cook has 3 3-pointers. He has 9. And Anton Berry, who had a hot first half, ends the game with 21. J.J. Foster Jr., he has 7 3-pointers tonight to lead all scorers for this game. Bishop Luers runs a record to 14-7, and they will wait to play Friday night, where they will host Huntington North at 7:30 on senior night here at Bishop Luers High School. That does it here from Bishop Luers High School, where Bishop Luers wins by 10, 69-59 over the New Haven Bulldogs. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Parkview Sports Medicine, Sports Center Inc., and the News Sentinel. For my cameraman, Nick, I'm Ryan Dellinger, and you have been watching High School Basketball, live High School Basketball, brought to you by SummitCitySports.com.